Now see the sixth question. In figure, diagonals AC and BD of quadrilateral ABCD intersect at O such that OB is equals to OD. If AB is equals to CD, then show that. Now see the figure. It is given that this OB is equals to OD and AB is equals to CD. Okay? We have to show that area of DOC is equals to area of AOB in first part, and in second part area of DCB is equals to area of ACB. Okay? And in third part DA is parallel to CB, this DA is parallel to CB, or ABCD is a parallelogram. This we have to prove. Now first of all we have done one construction in this question. What was construction? Draw perpendicular DM and BN from D and B respectively to AC. This DM and this BN are the perpendiculars. Okay, that means this angle is equals to 90 degree. Now we will prove the first part. So for first part, take triangle DMO and triangle BNO. Now in these two triangles, these two angles are equals to 190 degree. So angle DMO equals to angle BNO each 90 degree. Okay, and these two angles are vertically opposite angles, so they will be equal. So angle DOM equals to angle BON vertically opposite angles. Okay, and in our question it is given that BO is equals to OD, so we can write DO is equals to OB or BO, it is given to us. Now by AAS congruence rule we can say that these both triangles are congruent. So triangle DMO is congruent to triangle BNO. Now if these two triangles are congruent, then this DM will be equals to this BN by CPCT. Okay, name this as equation number 1. Now if these two triangles are congruent, then their areas will also be equal. So we can write area of DMO is equals to area of BNO by CPCT. Name this as equation number 2. Now in triangle DMC and BNA, in these two triangles angle DMC is 90 degree. Okay, so DMC is equals to angle BNA, this is also 90 degree, so we can write each 90 degree. And DM equals to BN, this is from equation number 1. Okay, and CD is equals to AB, this is given to us in question. Now again see, one is right angle and one is hypotenuse and other is side. Okay, so by RHS congruence rule, triangle DMC is congruent to triangle BNA. Now again if these two triangles are congruent, then their area will also be equal. So we can write therefore area of triangle DMC is equals to area of triangle BNA by CPCT, and name this as equation number 3. Now what we will do, we will add equation number 2 and 3. First add the left hand side. So area of DMO plus area of DMC, area of DMO plus DMC is equals to, now add RHS, area of BNO plus area of BNA. Okay, now see the LHS, area of DMO plus DMC, these two triangles will form this full triangle, that is triangle DOC. Okay, so sum of these two will be equal to area of DOC is equals to, now see the RHS, BNO this triangle, and BNA this triangle. Now sum of these two triangles will be this triangle, so area of triangle AOB. Okay, so this is what we have to prove in first part. So here you can write, hence proved. So we have proved the first part. Now see the second part. Now for second part, see, just now we have proved that these two triangles are equal in area. So we will write area of DOC equals to area of AOB. DOC equals to area of AOB. This we have proved just now, okay, in the first part. Now what we will do, we will add area of BOC on both sides. So area of DOC plus area of BOC is equals to again area of AOB plus area of BOC. We have added this area of BOC on both sides, okay. Now see, area of DOC plus BOC, BOC, area of these two triangles will be equal to area of this triangle, which is equal to area of DCB, okay. So left hand side will be equal to area of DCB is equals to, now see RHS, AOB, this is AOB, okay, then plus BOC, this is BOC. Now sum of these two triangles is equals to this ACB, okay. So here what will come, area of ACB, and this is what we have to prove in second part. So this is proved, so we can write here, hence proved. Now see the third part. In third part, again, just now in the first part, we have proved that this triangle is congruent to this triangle. We have proved this in first part. So we can write here, triangle DMC is congruent to triangle BNA. This we have proved above in the first part. Okay. And if these two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding parts will be equal. Okay, so angle DCM, this angle, will be equals to angle BAN, this angle, by CPCT. Okay, by CPCT, these two angles will be equal. Now we can see that these two angles are alternate interior angles and they are equal. Okay, now if these are alternate interior angles, that means these two lines will be parallel. So we can write, hence CD is parallel to AB. Okay, and it is given to us that CD is equals to AB. Okay, this is given to us. Now since one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, we can say that this ABCD is a parallelogram. So here you will write, since one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, therefore ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so our sixth question is completed. Now see the seventh question. D and E are points on sides AB and AC respectively of triangle ABC. D and E are the points on triangle ABC, okay, such that area of DBC is equals to area of EBC. Okay, now prove that DE is parallel to BC. This we have to prove. Now see the solution. Triangle DBC, DBC, this triangle, and triangle EBC, EB and C, this triangle. Okay, these two triangles are on same base BC. Base of both the triangles are same, that is BC. Okay, and it is also given that area of both the triangles are equal. That means area of DBC is equals to area of EBC. Now what we have studied, that if two triangles are of same base and between same parallels, then their area is equal. Now in this it is given that same base is there and their area is same. That means they will be between same parallel lines. Okay, so if the base of both the triangles is same and area of both the triangles are same, that means they will be between same parallel lines. They are between BC and D, that means BC will be parallel to D or DE will be parallel to BC. So we can write, therefore DE is parallel to BC. Okay, and the reason we will write, triangles on the same base and having equal areas lie between same parallel lines. Okay, the triangles which have same base and have same areas will always lie between same parallel lines. Okay, that means these two are parallel, and this is what we have to prove. So you can write, hence proved. Thank you everyone. If you like my videos, please like, subscribe and share my channel, and stay connected with A1 study classes.